Hi, Brian here. Today, we're gonna make a new bitboard, so stay tuned. So I had to come and do a redo on my editing. My audio didn't turn out very well, so I've already got the bitboard done, and we'll show you how we did that later, but with this one, I had a bit of a problem, and I was getting the dog bones here. And so I'm gonna show you what I did on how I fixed that. I did a couple different tests on bits, and I also found that some of my X-Carve needed some fine tuning, and I'll show you that. But that's the whole reason, is this just wasn't working for me, so we had to redo it. So I'll show you that and explain what we did later on. The first thing I did was make sure I had my Z probe set, and then I did my 1/8 straight cut bit, and I was checking to see how well it would carve. The first thing I was looking for was to see if it was gonna dog bone. And as it starts carving, you can see it already is dog boning up on that top right corner. So I knew that there was a problem going on. So after this stage carve, I needed to look and see how well my belts were, and if any of the wheels were a little too loose beyond touch. All right, so one of the things we want to check when we get these dog bones is to make sure that this isn't loose by checking these wheels. I can tell you right now, that is way too loose. That should not be adjusting like that. So we'll have to get a wrench in here and adjust it there. All right, so that's good. We're good there. We want to make sure that that is tight. For the second test, I still used a 1/8 bit, but now that I've got those wheels tightened up, I wanted to see if we were still dog boning. Had just a little bit there on the dog bone, but nowhere near as much as the first carve. So I went back and looked at my belts to see if my belts needed tightening. I then switched bits to a 1/8 end mill just to see if it would result in having any dog boning. And this was the cleanest cut. So I thought, you know, I'd keep this in and see what it does. Okay, so looking at this, this row right here was before tightening. That row was after tightening. And then this row up here was with a completely different bit. I think then the end mill and not the straight is the bit to go for this. Even though Inventables recommends the straight cut, I'm gonna go against the recommendation because I think it looks better. And I think that's gonna prove what I need to do here. So partially through the carve, when I got done doing my first little line here, I switched it back to the 1/8 straight bit versus the end mill because I wanted to see what the differences were, to see if it was going to make any bit of a difference. And I ended up keeping the straight cut bit. I'm thinking I probably should have trusted my instinct and stayed with the end mill just because I think it did a better job. An additional thing that I learned is when you're carving specific parts, you want to make sure that everything's going to fit right. And so when you're doing specific bits and pieces, you're gonna wanna go in and make sure they fit. As you see here, that's a little bit of a tight fit. So that gives me the opportunity to go back and go into easel and enlarge these if needed. That was a little tight, but you know, it works for me, so I'm gonna keep it that way. If you'd like it looser though, you can go in and copy those in easel, put them to a new profile and hit paste, and enlarge them a little bit just so it'll fit the way that you want it to fit. Another thing, as you can see, there's a lot of dust in those pockets, a lot of sawdust. So you'll want to make sure that you're clearing out those pockets as best as possible in order for the dust chew to collect all of the sawdust. Lastly, you're just going to want to vacuum up all of the sawdust out of the pockets. Take a fine grit sand to your project to make sure that there's no furries anywhere. Give it a nice clean kind of wipe down, re-vacuum. And before you remove your clamps, it's always highly recommended to test fit your different bits and clamps that you're wanting to put into your work surface here to ensure they fit. If not, copy those selected areas that don't fit into another project page on easel and then enlarge as needed. That way you've still got your exact spacing of where the pieces go, and you don't need to worry about re-zeroing because you can zero at last 0 point. Alright, so that's it for the Bitboard. If you liked what you saw, consider subscribing. Please give it a like if you like it. And I'll have this posted down in the link description below. So that way, if you want to carve anything that you've seen on the video, it's here for you. Thanks for watching.